If you could see the setup I have right now, you'd crack up. Want me to show you? Check this out. Hopefully I don't drop anything. Look at that. This is the setup. Yep. Crazy. That's it. See, I let you behind the scenes. With lines of latitude, parallels, they are always parallel to each other, about 69 miles between one degree of latitude and the next degree of latitude. However, with lines of longitude, meridians, they are not parallel to each other. Remember, lines of longitude, meridians, are half circles, 180 degrees. Half circles drawn from pole to pole, South Pole, North Pole, okay? Half circles drawn from pole to pole that connect points of equal longitude. What that implies and what it means is that all lines of longitude converge at the poles. They all come together, okay? And remember, there's 360 degrees of longitude. So if you were at the prime meridian, which is right here, this line right here, coming down, my finger deviated a little, but you see where it's at, okay? If you're at the prime meridian and the equator, so where those two places intersect right here, and you went all the way around the planet, all the way into the eastern hemisphere, all the way through the western hemisphere, and came back to the place where you started, right there, what would happen is you would travel about 25,000 miles. If, however, you went through the exact same 360 degrees of longitude and you were standing at the North or South Pole, here's what you do to go through the entire 360 degrees of longitude at the North or South Pole. There you go. That's it. You spin in a circle. It's the exact same 360 degrees of longitude because when you look, you can see that all of the lines of longitude are converging at the poles. See, they're all coming in right here at the South Pole. Look at them all coming in. They're all converging there. And then at the North Pole, the same thing. All the lines of longitude are all converging at the poles. They all come together. They do not remain parallel. They meet each other. Okay? So that sets up a kind of funny thing. When you were a kid learning the continents, North America, South America, Europe, Africa, Asia, Australia, Antarctica, there you are, you're looking at them. There they are. When you were learning these, there's Antarctica down there. When you were learning these, you probably looked at Greenland and said, if South America is a continent, how come Greenland is not a continent? They're about the same size. Well, here's the thing. Greenland's big. Biggest island on Earth is Greenland. But that is South America. This is Greenland. This is South America. I mean, you could almost put Greenland in the Amazon, you wouldn't even know it was there. I one time took a flight from Buenos Aires to Panama, and it was a 7-hour flight, which means longer than going from LA to New York. South America is a huge bit of real estate. The question, obviously, is why does Greenland look like this? Well, this is a flat map, and you cannot accurately represent spherical objects like the planet as it is on a flat map. In order to represent the planet, you're going to have distortions if you take this spherical object and try and imprint it onto a flat map. And the distortions work like this. Remember what I just told you about those lines of longitude, that they all converge at the poles, they all come together right at the poles? If you look at this map right here, this is the prime meridian. This would be the North Pole, and what you can't see down here, this is the South Pole. There you go, there's my finger. Yeah? Okay. Here's all these other lines of longitude. Notice none of them, except for the prime meridian, is actually reaching the North and South Poles, which means what's happening is on the top of this map and on the bottom of the map as well, everything is being stretched out because all of these lines of longitude are all stretching out across the top of the map, and they're not reaching the North or South Pole where they are supposed to be converging. The result of that is that the entire top of the map is all distorted. The bottom of the map, mostly ocean, but it's all distorted too. And the result of that is that Greenland looks massive on this map, when in reality, it's big. But Greenland is no South America. Senator, I knew South America. South America was a friend of mine. And Greenland, you are no South America.